And that's Charlie standing right behind me. Why a horse? You might well ask. Warhorse has been performing now for the last 5 years in London, New York, Toronto, and is about to open right here in Melbourne, Australia at the end of the year. This Broadway hit was a collaboration between the National Theatre in London and Handspring Puppet Company in South Africa. What's really fascinating is the way puppetry has moved into the mainstream of world theatre over the few years. I remember the days when you couldn't get an adult into the theatre to watch puppetry. Today, you can't keep them out. We are privileged today to have with us the puppetry director, Mr. Finn Caldwell, who shall explain a little bit more about these miraculous horses in Warhorse and how they move and keep the audience riveted while watching the show.
Adrian Kohler, who's the main designer, spent a long time studying the anatomy of horses. So the horses actually want to move the way a real horse moves. The aesthetic of the horses is a little bit more abstract though. So actually really they're like the sketch of a horse, or like the idea of a horse. And it's through a combination of these really sophisticatedly designed and built puppets and the magic of the performers that are trained to use them that they come to life.
What about breath? Yes. How important is the aspect of breathing life into these so-called inanimate objects?
That's a bit of an insider question, isn't
it? Indeed.
Yeah, indeed. Well, breath's really important. Breath is very much at the heart of all of Handspring's work. It's through showing a puppet. Yeah, if you've ever seen puppets, they have life, and by breathing we actually get to show that the puppet is alive on stage, because that's the difference perhaps between an actor and a puppet, because an actor can come on stage and it's automatically understood that they're alive.
Whereas not always.
Well, no, that's very true. Some actors not less alive than others. But breath really starts to tell us about the life of the puppet. It also tells us about the emotional state of the puppet, tells us what they're physiologically going through. And it's a good way for anybody operating a puppet to be able to communicate with anybody else. So in our horse puppets, we have three puppeteers, and one of the main ways that they communicate with one another is not through words, but through breath.
Tell me, why puppetry is a mode of expression?
Gosh, that's a big question, isn't it? I don't know. I think because of the sense of play. Ooh. I think the sort of honesty of, admitting that theatre is like a game. It's a game between the audience and the performers on stage. And I love the sort of the artifice of puppets and the fact that they represent something, and they encourage us to use our imaginations to bring them to life. The audience are required to take part in the bringing of the puppet to life on stage, and I think that's just sort of a magical process that I'm drawn to.
I heard on the radio this morning that you are auditioning puppeteers for Warhorse.
Yeah.
Do you think I might stand a chance?
Absolutely, yeah, you should come along. We'll put you on the horse and see what happens. How strong are you?
Oh, I'm super strong.
Yeah, that's quite big muscles.
Yes,
yeah,
indeed.
Yeah. Have you operated puppets before?
I do every day, sir.
Do you?
I have one below me.
Really?
Yes, indeed.
Oh, right. Bring him along. Maybe he can audition.
Yeah, thank you. Yes, I would like to thank Finn Caldwell of Handspring Puppet Company, and thank you, our worldwide audience, for joining us here today at the Arts Centre in Melbourne. This is Conquest, reporting for Puppetry News here in Melbourne.